Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at substitution reactions of diazonium salts. So this product over here is a diazonium salt, and it allows for a wide functionalization of benzene derivatives because of this excellent leaving group N2. So let's start with how we make a diazonium salt. We need an aniline derivative. So this specific molecule is aniline. You've got an NH2 group on there. You could have other groups as well, but you need that NH2 group. If I put those in solution with sodium nitrite and HCl, those will generate the electrophile here. And that will be attacked by the lone pair of electrons on the nitrogen on my aniline derivative. And that introduces the second nitrogen, which will ultimately generate the diazonium salt. So I get an intermediate that looks like this. And then this is going to lose an equivalent of water. So these H's and this oxygen will come off. So I'm going to say minus H2O. And that will generate my diazonium salt. And from there, I can do a lot of functionalizations of benzene to introduce different nucleophiles and generate different benzene derivatives. So let's go to the next page and we'll take a look at what we can accomplish with this new diazonium salt and the excellent N2 leaving group. So here I have a reaction scheme where I start with a diazonium salt, and then I have a series of different reagents over the arrows to show all of the functionalizations that I can accomplish using this leaving group. So the mechanism is going to vary depending on what the reagents are. These copper-containing compounds seen here are referred to as Sandmeyer reactions. The copper facilitates a radical-type mechanism. Some of the other mechanisms vary. But given what you already know based off substitution reactions, you can just use your knowledge of leaving groups and the nucleophilic atoms in order to predict the product. So we have this really good leaving group in N2. It's going to make N2 gas in all these cases. And then I've color-coded our reagents to indicate the nucleophilic atom. So based off what we already know about substitution reactions and what we know about salts and dipole moments and electronegativity, we can look at, you know, what is going to be the atom with the negative or the partial negative charge, and that will allow us to predict our products. So for this top reaction, I would be making phenol. I'm introducing water under acidic conditions, and that would give me OH as my final neutralized product. So that's a phenol derivative. With the copper chloride, I would get chlorobenzene. With the copper bromide, I would get bromobenzene. With the copper cyanide, I would get cyanobenzene. So remember, that's a triple bond between carbon and nitrogen, that condensed formula with the missing full octet. If you look at the carbon, right, it looks like it doesn't have four things around it. That infers that it must have a triple bond. That's how I know it's a triple bond there. The bottom would give me, this would be iodobenzene. And then for fluorobenzene, you have to combine, because of the decreased activity of the fluorine, some hydrogen fluoride with BF3. And that makes that HBF4 complex, but that would give you fluorobenzene. And in all these cases, you're going to evolve nitrogen gas from your leaving group. So you can see there's a variety of functional groups we can introduce via this reaction. This has been a look at the substitution reaction of aryl diazonium salts. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.